Space. An endless void whose secrets are still unknown to science. A flawless system of galaxies and the stars, planets, comets, asteroids, and clouds of gas and dust all moving together in perfect harmony. And the Milky Way. The giant star system of which our solar system is a part. We shall soon examine this magnificent system from one end to the other. Our journey will be the furthest planet from our Pluto. Lying cold. Its surface temperature is around -238 degrees. Of that, turning into a block of ice. Frozen planet. Surface. The atmosphere consists of and methane is the atmosphere a blue color. This is a deadly world, racked by terrible storms moving at up to 2,000 kilometers an hour. Largely consisting of rock and ice. It's 84 Earth years to orbit the Sun. Saturn. This is the second biggest planet in our particularly well-known system of rings. These rings are made up of gas. The planet itself is gas, 75% helium. Its density Jupiter. The biggest planet in the solar system. Also a gaseous planet. It is 318 times the size of Earth. Red mark is a storm large enough. There is no land on it. An insane cold. Terrible storms that last for hundreds of years. A magnetic field that could kill any. Dreadful and Mars. Its atmosphere is a poisonous mixture with high levels of carbon dioxide, caused by striking meteors and deep pits of kilometers long. rock ruled by violent winds. Venus. Planets. Venus. On its surface, lead around 450 dioxide. It's at high. Constantly the nearest planet to the Sun. It spins around its own axis. Since its days and nights are long, one such an environment would be fatal to any living thing. As this of the nine planets in our solar system and all their 53 moons are incapable of sustaining life. Silent rock. However, one planet in this system, one that we have not looked at yet, is very different from the others. Because all its features, from its atmosphere to the makeup of its surface, and to its distance from the Sun, have been created in the best manner for sustaining life. That system, the planet for their harmonious balance of love and in the seas. Millions of animals, plants, insects, and sea creatures, all with creatures live together on this special planet. This equilibrium on Earth and all the living things on it are his creation. He invites mankind to consider these things in one verse of the Quran. It is God who created the heavens with no support. You can see them. And cast firmly embedded mountains on the earth so that it would not move under you. And scattered about in it creatures of every kind. And we send down water from the sky and make every generous species grow in it. This is God's creation. The survival on Earth is as great a miracle as its creation. That survival has special conditions of life. In the tiny yet in the absence of any intervention from outside, no such thing will happen. The blue planet has a number of special features to maintain. Thanks to these features, and unlike its neighbors, it offers an extremely beautiful at some of these miraculous features of the blue planet and seeing how they of chance. We shall witness the blue planet has both a temperature that is inhabitable and an atmosphere that is breathable for living things. These two extremely different factors, however, have come into being as a result of conditions that turn out to be ideal for both. One of these is the distance between the Earth and the Sun. As near the Sun as Venus is, or as far from it as Jupiter. When one considers the universe as a whole, coming across a range of temperatures as narrow as this is quite a difficult task. Temperatures vary from the millions of degrees of the hottest stars to absolute zero, which corresponds to a temperature of minus 273 degrees Celsius. In such a vast range of temperatures, the thermal interval that allows life to exist is slim indeed. But our planet Earth has it. American geologists, Frank, temperatures prevailing on Earth. They note that it is possible over a very narrow 2% of the range between a temperature of 1. Related to the amount of heat as well as the Sun. According to calculation, 10% in the surface being covered, and if that were to increase by a little, scorched and die. heat must also be distributed fairly equally over the number of special precautions have been taken to ensure that this in fact happens. The Earth's axis is tilted at an angle of 23 degrees, 27 degrees, the plane of the Earth's orbit around the inclination prevents over poles and the equator and the temperature zones to live in. Speed of Earth on its axis keep the thermal distribution. Earth makes a complete rotation once periods of daylight. Because they are short, the thermal sides of the planet is quite modest. As the rotational speed of Mercury on its axis is so slow, a day temperatures is almost 1,000 degrees centigrade. Measurable temperature difference would allow nothing. Geography also helps to distribute heat equally over the Earth. The polar and equatorial regions of Earth. If such a thermal were to exist in a level area, the result would be speeds as high as 1,000 km away everything in their path. Full of geographic the huge movements of and would otherwise cause. These are chains of mountains. At the same time, there are a number of auto-control systems that help keep the atmospheric temperature in balance. For example, when a region heats up, the rate at which its water vaporizes increases, causing clouds to form. These clouds reflect more light back into space and make rain fall. This prevents both the air and the surface below from growing warmer. The mass of the Earth is no less important for life than its distance from the Sun, its rotational speed, or physical features. Looking at the planets, we see a great range of masses. Mercury, for instance, is 8% of the mass of the Earth, while Jupiter is 318 times bigger. The size of Earth as compared with other planets coincidental, or is it deliberate? When we examine the planet, we see that our planet was designed to be exactly the size it is. American geologists Frank Press and Raymond Sever comment on Earth's fitness. And Earth's size was just about right. Not too small as it was too small to prevent gases from escaping into space, including harmful gases. In addition to its mass, the interior of Earth is also specially designed with features that go round down to its core. These layers are in motion and that allows us to navigate by compass. Migrating birds to find their formations. What is more, this field that extends even beyond the atmosphere also forms a protective shield that defends might come lethal cosmic rays in space are unable to protective shield that surrounds the Earth. The greater part of the plasma clouds formed by solar explosions are deflected by this magnetic field. The remainder of the event are diverted to the polar region, suited to life. Region form a magnificent light display in the sky. If this protective shield did not exist, harmful radiation would come into existence at all. Thanks to this magnetic field, form possesses a magnificent defensive shield. God has reminded people the sky a preserve, yet still they turn away. Earth's physical features, temperature and so on, are life. Such features alone are not to exist on Earth, however. The main factor is the composition of the atmosphere. Need people. One example of this in these films. Astronauts approaching a distant planet in their spacecraft look to see whether the atmosphere is breathable or not before landing. When the computer on their ship reports that the atmosphere is suitable, there is no need for any further protective measures. Give people the impression that mankind could easily and this is not true at all. The possibility of another planet's having an atmosphere that we could breathe is minute. LZ-56. That is because the atmosphere of the Earth is specially designed to support life in a number of crucial ways. This atmosphere, it is impossible to survive. The atmosphere of Earth is composed of 77% nitrogen, 21% oxygen, dioxide. Let's start with an important gas. Oxygen is vital to life because it enters into most of the chemical reactions that release the energy that the complex life human beings require. The interesting aspect of this is that the percentage of breathe is very precisely determined. In his book, Nature Biology Reveal Purpose in famous professor of microbiology, Michael Denton, writes, "Could your atmosphere contain more oxygen and still support life?" Is close to the upper limit of safety for life at ambient temperature. The probability of a forest fire being ignited increases by as much of oxygen in the air remains a precise result of a marvelous animals consume oxygen and produce carbon dioxide. For them, it's not breathable. Just the opposite. They take in carbon dioxide, which they need to, and release oxygen in. So life goes on. Plants release millions of tons of oxygen into the the cooperative groups of living things, our planet would be uninhabitable. For example, took in carbon dioxide and oxygen, the air would more easily than it does. It could set off enormous fires. Both took in oxygen and released carbon dioxide, life would eventually die out when all the oxygen However, quickly set up that the oxygen in the atmosphere is always at the ideal level for life. A balance designed and perfect at every moment. Once again, that Lord of the earth is the God calls on man to consider this truth in a verse from the Quran. Do you not see that God has supplied earth and has showered his blessings upon you, both outwardly and we breathe every moment of life. We air in normal. In fact, quite a complex process. System when we inhale oxygen 300 tiny chambers in lungs. Capillaries surrounding these chambers absorb the oxygen. The whole thing takes less than a second. Carbon dioxide goes out. ...300 chambers maximize the air. Point here that we need to keep in mind. Surrounding them perfectly in order at which oxygen and carbon on other the dead all be right in order for an example will help us to understand this more clearly. It is easy to draw water up with a syringe, but it would be difficult if we tried to draw honey up instead. That is because honey has a higher viscosity and is denser than water. If the density, viscosity, and pressure of air were higher, breathing would be as difficult as drawing honey into a needle. Whereas we are able to breathe perfectly comfortably without even being aware we are doing it. is the atmosphere's features and arithmetical values. Molecular biologist Professor Michael Denton makes this comment. If air were much greater, the airway resistance would be prohibitive. Space of all possible atmospheres. The earth breathe for our blue planet to stay blue. If sea level atmospheric pressure were much lower than its present value, the rate of water vaporization water in the atmosphere, trapping more heat and raising the average temperature of the planet. On the other hand, if the pressure were much higher, the rate of water vaporization would be parts of the examples we have seen throughout this film show that the Earth was specially created for life. The thing so far are delicate differences that are essential for life on Earth. We can make the American astronomer Hugh Ross has made a list of his own in his book, The Creator and the Cosmos. Surface would retain too much ammonia and methane. If weaker, the planet's atmosphere would lose too much. Crust. If thicker, too much. Too great. Temperature differences would be too great. If shorter, atmosphere ozone level in the atmosphere. If greater, surface temperature would be too low. And there would be too much greater, too many life forms would be destroyed. Floors from river runoffs would not be recycled to the continents through tectonic uplift. These balances, of which we have cited only a few examples, once again maintains that the universe came in is a great deception. The evidence revealed by created and all man's duty is to give thanks to God who created him and the entire universe. In the verse of the Quran, God addresses people in these terms. It is God who made the earth and the sky and formed you, giving you and provided you with good and holy. It is God, your Lord. Be God, the Lord of all the worlds.